Ring opening polymerization is a type of chain growth polymerization in which cyclic monomer is converted into a linear polymer. For example, epoxides gives polyether, caprolactone gives polycaprolactone, caprolactam gives nylon 6 on polymerization. Silicons are also prepared by ring opening polymerization from cyclosiloxanes. Polymers synthesized by ring opening polymerizations are typically synthesized by step growth polymerization. Now you can ask a question, if we can synthesize these polymers by step growth polymerization, then what is the need of ring opening polymerization? The reason is, cyclic monomers cannot be polymerized by step growth polymerization. Also, by ring opening polymerization, we can make living polymers and other functional polymers, which is not possible in step growth polymerization. Now the most important question is, do all the cyclic monomers undergo polymerization or only specific monomers polymerize by ring opening? So feasibility of a monomer to undergo ring opening polymerization depends on two factors. First is thermodynamic and second is kinetic factor. When we are talking about thermodynamic factor, basically we are talking about ring strain. 3-4 membered rings are highly strained rings due to bond angle. 5 membered ring possess strain due to steric repulsion. 7 and 8 membered rings are strained due to transannular strain. Whereas 6 membered rings show minimum strain due to staggered conformation. The order of thermodynamic feasibility to undergo ring opening is highest for 3-4 membered ring, then 8 and then 7 and 5 membered rings. Now let's take example of cycloalkanes. Can we polymerize cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclopentane monomers into a linear polymer, as these monomers show thermodynamic feasibility to undergo ring opening polymerization? The answer is no. Although thermodynamically it is possible to polymerize these monomers, but they do not have kinetic pathway to carry out the polymerization, as these are saturated rings with sigma bond and there is no bond where an initiator can attack and facilitate polymerization. This shows that all the cyclic monomers cannot be polymerized by ring opening polymerization. Having a cyclic monomer with high strain is not enough. So what else we need in the monomer to undergo ring opening polymerization? To carry out the polymerization reaction, cyclic monomer must contain a heteroatom in the ring structure. The presence of a heteroatom in the ring provides a site for attack by an initiator species, which leads to initiation and propagation of growing chain. Examples of such monomers are cyclic ethers, lactams, lactones, acetal, and other cyclic monomers. So, for ring opening polymerization, monomers must contain a strained ring and a heteroatom in the ring structure. Now, if we look at the reaction mechanism and kinetics, like chain growth polymerization, ring opening polymerization also involves a sequence of initiation, propagation, and termination step. Ring opening polymerizations are generally initiated by same type of cationic and anionic initiators used for the polymerization of vinyl monomers. Ring opening polymerization also shows the same characteristics as ionic polymerization, such as effect of solvent, counter ion, propagation by different species, and termination step. Like ionic polymerization, if the reaction is carried out in controlled condition and there are no impurities, living polymers with high molecular weight and narrow polydispersity can be achieved. We can also make block copolymers, graft copolymers, and other functional polymers using living polymers. One similarity that ring opening polymerization has with the step growth polymerization is that the propagation rate constant is the same. Therefore, they are actually several order of magnitude lower than the normal chain polymerization. As a result, molecular weight increases slowly, which depends on percentage conversion of monomer to initiator or vice versa. Now, if we look at the mechanism of polymerization reaction, anionic ring opening polymerization involves nucleophilic reagents as initiator, such as metal hydroxide, metal alcoxide, alkyl metal, etc. Monomers with a 3 or 4-membered ring structure such as epoxides, aziridines and episulfides undergo anionic ring opening polymerization. Due to electron withdrawing nature of hetero atom, the functional group gets polarized. The carbon atom become electron deficient. The nucleophilic initiator attacks on this carbon atom and the bond between carbon atom and hetero atom breaks and a new nucleophile form. Now, this nucleophile attacks the carbon atom in another monomer molecule and the process will keep on going until the polymer is formed. Whereas, in case of cationic polymerization, electrophilic agents are used as initiator, such as strong protonic acid like Lewis acids. Cyclic monomers that polymerize through this mechanism includes lactones, lactams, amines and ethers. This time, initiator is an electrophile, so it attacks the hetero atom, making it positively charged species. The nucleophilic monomer attacks on the electrophilic carbon atom and the chain grows by the addition of cyclic monomers. Like ionic polymerization, termination reactions are absent in ring opening polymerization too, but termination may occur by chain transfer to monomer, counter ion, solvent and polymer. Most monomers can be polymerized by either of the two mechanisms. It depends on the type of initiator used for the polymerization. For example, caprolactone can be polymerized to polycaprolactone by both cationic and anionic method. Another example is polymerization of cyclic ether. Also, we learn that 6-membered rings do not undergo ring opening polymerization. But 1,3,5-trioxane undergoes cationic ring opening polymerization, whereas tetrahydropyron and dioxane do not polymerize. These are the some commercial polymers synthesized by ring opening polymerization. This polymerization gives polymers that contains functional groups that can be easily broken, which allows the development of various degradable polymers. But there are not many commercial polymers produced by this method because the cyclic monomers required for polymerization are not nearly as available as bifunctional monomers for the step growth polymerization. So mostly polymers are synthesized by step growth polymerization. But to synthesize multifunctional polymers, mainly ring opening polymerization is used. So that's all for today. If you like the video, please subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.